Okay, for this video, I'll be discussing terrorism and other political crimes. So basically, I'm discussing here contemporary forms of terrorism, okay? Yung mga purpose ng terrorism and yung mga terrorist groups, terrorist group. And eventually, in my next video, I'm discussing political crimes also. Now, let us start with the contemporary forms of terrorism. So when you say contemporary, ito yung mga modern. Modern forms of terrorism. Mga bagong dahilan ng mga terrorists na may be engaged in terroristic activity. Okay? So, number one is yung natawag natin revolutionary terrorists. From the word revolution. Okay, revolution. Revolutionary terrorists from world revolution. Use of violence to frighten those in power and their supporters in order, the purpose, in order to replace existing government with a regime that holds acceptable political and religious view. So, itong klaseng terrorism, ang purpose talaga is to replace existing government, no? Panuod revolution. Okay? Terrorist actions such as kidnapping, assassination, and bombing are designed to draw repressive responses from governments trying to defend themselves. So, yan yung revolutionary terrorist, no? They want to replace existing government. I think we have now civil war in Syria. Yan yung example ng revolutionary terrorism. Terrorists, they want to replace existing government. Ito lang tayo. If you remember yung Zamboanga siege, o yung attack ng MNLF or Moro National Liberation Front sa Zamboanga City sometime on September 9, 2013. Okay? Ano bang purpose? Bakit inatake ng grupo na to ang Zamboanga? Okay? Zamboanga City. Well, the MNLF gunman in Zamboanga have said that they are fighting for, ito gusto na, independent state. Independent state, not just an autonomy. Like yung bar natin ngayon, no? Bar Samoro, autonomous region. No? Hindi siya, ayun ng autonomy, gusto na independent state. Separate country talaga. Okay? So, they want to establish or overthrow an existing government. Okay? O bakit inatake ang maute at ng Abu Sayyaf ISIS ang Marawi City? Okay? Again, ito yung purpose nila, to establish caliphate where ISIS or Daesh will rule. So Daesh is other name for ISIS. So ito ha, sa picture at makita natin si Estilon Hapilon at Maute Brothers nagpupulong sa Marawi para sa planong pag-atake. Okay? So, and then, the purpose of the group is to establish a caliphate, a separate state, okay, Muslim state, gusto nila. So, that is, they want, again, to replace existing government, topple down government. Yan yung purpose ng pag-atake nila doon. So, dito, makikita natin, no? Ano ang kaibahan ng Zamboanga siege at saka ng Marawi siege? Of course, yung Zamboanga nangyari sometime September 2013. Yung Marawi, May, I think, 23, 2017. No? Sinong may pakalan sa Zamboanga siege? Ang MNLF, no? Kay Noemi Suwari. Ang Marawi, ang Maute at saka ASG, si Estel Napilo, no? At saka Maute Brothers. Yung strength dito, 500. Yung strength dito, 800. Duration, 20 days. Tapos na. Dito, 5 months umabot yung Marawi siege. Hanggang ngayon, hindi pa nakabalik yung mga tao sa Marawi, no? Still, in the evacuation center. Dito, 25 yung killed, government casualty. Dito, 163 yung killed, mga gubat mo, no? So, but, another important thing to do or to note here is, no martial law was declared on Zamboanga siege, but dito sa Marawi siege, nag-declare si Duterte na martial law within Mindanao. Okay, within Mindanao. So, ano namang nationalist terrorism, okay? It promotes interests of minority ethnic and religious groups. So, ito yung, why? Because they believe that it has been persecuted under majority rule. So, yung mga minority, okay, they believe that they're being persecuted by majority, they want to promote their interests. Okay? Wala naman silang plano nag, mayroon siya plano din na to carve its own independent homeland. But basically, ang unang purpose nila is to promote their interest, yung religion nila at saka yung pagiging minority nila. And an example of this is what is happening in Middle East, especially in Israel and Palestine. Kasi may ongoing war doon ngayon, no? Hanggang ngayon. No? We have the Palestinian Liberation Organization, PLO, have directed terrorist activities against Israel because they want to get Gaza Strip and West Bank, no? West Bank. So, sino ang splinter ng PLO? Splinter groups are broken from PLO. These groups are Hamas. Yung Hamas is galing sa PLO yan. At saka Iranian back, Hezbollah. So, itong dalawang terrorist group din ito, no? They are also attacking Israel. Ang kalaban nila ito, Israel. No? And they cause bombings against Israel. No? Pinagtulungan nila ang Israel. Ito ninyo. Ito yung Israel. Ito yung Gaza Strip na pinagagawa. At saka West Bank. Nandito yung Palestine. Gusto nilang makuha. Gusto nilang mapromote yung religion nila ng Muslim. Kaya inatake nila yung Israel. Ayaw naman bitawan ng Israel yung Palestine at saka yung Gaza Strip. Okay? Kaya may ibang grupo, Hezbollah, no? Mas umatake din sa Israel. Maraming kalaban ng Israel. Ito, in 12 months time, according to United Nations data, sa Gaza Strip borders protest, 190 na yung patay. Okay? Kasi yung ngayon, nag-away pa rin yung Israel at saka yung Gaza. Okay, borders, no? And 28,000 are injured in a year of bloodshed. So, hanggang ngayon, still disputed, ano yan, disputed area yan. Now, cause-based terrorism. Some terrorists expose particular social or religious cause. So, ito, depends lang religious cause. Okay, or social cause. Use violence to attract followers to their standard. Ito. They do not wish to set up their own homeland or topple government, but rather want to attack and intimate groups that oppose their social and religious views. So, wala silang planong mag-set up ng sariling homeland or topple a government. Wala. They just want to expose their social and religious cause. Okay? Like, for example, ano mga social cause yan? Ito, anti-abortion groups. Kasi sa Amerika, you know, in America, no, parang kasing yung sex yun, parang dyan, ano na yun, play lang yun, no? Marami yung nagpa-abort. And marami din may mga tao din na anti-abortion groups. Anong ginagawa nila? Demonstrated abortion clinics, and some members attacked clients, bomb offices, and killed doctors who perform abortion. So, yun yung ginagawa nila. Inatake nila yung mga offices, yung mga clinic, yung mga doctor, pinapatay, who are performing abortion. Okay? Anti-abortion groups yan. Okay? Now, ito. Another good example of nationalist cause-based terrorism is yung nangyari sa France. Ito ay isang kilalang Charlie Hebdo is actually a satirical magazine in France. Okay? And this Charlie Hebdo magazine, palagi niyang inatake yung Allah at saka Muhammad ng mga Muslim. Kaya nagalit yung mga Muslim groups din sa France at pinapatay nila yung mga editor. Ito, pinapatay nila. Ito, konti lang nalang ito nandito. Pero 12 people were killed in terror attack against French satirical magazine Charlie Hebdo. So, 12 people ang namatay. Okay? Kasi nga, they want to promote their interests. No? So, mga Muslim to. Kaya nga, in the past few years, maraming terror attack sa France. Kasi maraming mga Muslim yung galit doon. Okay, terror attack sa France. Yan, ang dami. Oh. Dito, oh, dyan. Kaya nga, in one news report ng CNN, France at its highest terror level. Kasi ang dami ng terrorist attack doon. Okay? Sinong pinagbibigyan? Siyempre ng Muslim. Kaya yung Muslim magpuputas sa doon eh. Your Charlie, ano itong Your Charlie? Ito yung Charlie Hebdo magazine. And they are calling for respect for Islam. Okay? Kasi nga, inatake ng Charlie Hebdo magazine ang kanyang religion. And they want to promote their interest. Okay? The religious cause. Wala rin siyang planong itapple down yung French government. Wala. They just want to protect their interest or their religious views, no? So we have also what we call environmental terrorism. Environmental terrorism. So in August 22, 2003, members of extremist environmental group Earth Liberation Front, anong ginawa nito? Claim responsibility for fires that destroys a dozen of sport utility vehicles at Chevrolet dealership in West Covina, California. So sinuuli nila yung SUV. Okay, bakit? Because SUVs emit carbon monoxide. And we know carbon monoxide destroys our ozone layer. And if our ozone layer is destroyed, then probably do we have the so-called direct heat of the sun, baka magkasakit tayo, yung mga glaciers sa North Pole sa South Pole, baka matunaw yun, eh magkaroon ng water world, no? So we want to protect the environment. That's the purpose. They claim, they destroy rather than utility, exposure to utility vehicle, again, to protect the environment, no? And this was neither the first nor the most costly, no? Kasi on October 1998, several suspicious fires were set up in Vail Mountain, a luxurious ski resort in Colorado. Resort naman yung inatake nila in 1998 kasi nga they want to protect the environment. Okay, so yan. Earth Liberation Front and Environmental Terrorism, no? So, in many states, ito yung ginagawa nila, no? Ang daming, yan, 7 million US dollars yan. Ito sa Oregon, 3 million US dollars, no? Anong ginagawa nga? Arson, sinusunog yung mga resort, o ligaya yung mga sasakyan, okay? Attempted arson, or animal rescue, animal release, na-release na yung mga, nauling mga animals, and of course, vandalism, okay? Ito naman, ibang grupo naman to. This is not Earth Liberation Front. Ito yung PETA. People's Ethical Treatment of Animals. Wants you to go naked to help animals. Kasi, sabi nga, would you rather go naked than wear fur? That's PETA, no? And, you know, kasi sa Pilipinas, may nag-ano nito, may nag-rally. But, again, PETA is not a terrorist group, okay? Ano sila? Environmental protector lang, no? This is mga environmentalists into, no? They are, what they want to promote, na yung gamitin yung damit na galing sa animal fur. Because it kills an animal. They rather go naked than wear fur. So, yan yung protesta nila. But again, PETA is not a terrorist group. Ito lang Earth Liberation Front. But of course, their advocacy the same, no? Environmental protection. Then you have the state-sponsored terrorism. Okay, state-sponsored terrorism, yun say, ang state mismo, ang gobyerno mismo, ang nag-sponsor ng terrorism, ang nag-cause ng terrorism. State-sponsored terrorism occurred when repressive government, ang gobyerno mismo, repressive government, regime forces citizens into obedience, oppresses minorities, and supports political dissent. So, yung nagre-reklamo, yung mga opposition, pinapatay. That is state-sponsored terrorism. And death squad, yung paggamit ng death squad, and the use of government troops to destroy political opposition, okay, destroy political opposition are often associated with Latin America political terrorism. Example yun, Iran, Sudan, and Syria. So, yan yung mga state-sponsored terrorism. Ang Estado mismo. I think we have a good example that, no? Itong si President Marcos, he declared martial law on September 23, 1972. But what is his basis? No? Allegedly, ito, nasa Official Gazette to, no? Official Gazette is the newspaper, official newspaper of the government. The facts are clear. A week before actual declaration of martial law, a number of people had already received information that Marcos had drawn up a plan, planado na yan, to completely take over the government and gain absolute rule. Ito na yung plan niya. Gusto niyang kuha yung gobyerno. Okay? Same as Eric, tatapos na yung termino niya. Binigno Aquino Jr., during September 23, 1972, previous week, exposed was known as Oplan Sagittarius. So, ito yung plano nila, no? Na, ganyan. Marcos is going to use series of bombings in Metro Manila, including 1971 Plaza Marana, as justification for his takeover of civil authoritarian rule. So, again, para maka-declare si Marcos ng martial law, he sponsored a terrorist attack, yung mga bombings. And sa article na to, mabasa niyo rin din, yung attempted, or no, ambush, no, failed ambush against Enrile. Enrile the time is the Secretary of National Defense. Okay? So, because of the ambush of Enrile, the bombings, which is state-sponsored, yung Estado mismo ang magawa nun, Padre Marcos was able to declare martial law. Na-declare niya yung martial law. And that is a sample of state-sponsored terrorism. Ang gobyerno mismo ang nag-stage ng terrorism para naka-declare ng martial law. Okay? Then you have criminal terrorism. In December 2001, six men were arrested by Russian security forces as they were making deal with weapons-grade uranium. Itong weapons-grade uranium ito, ito yung formula or main ingredient para makagawa ng WMD. What is WMD? Ito yung mga weapons of mass destruction. Okay, yung mga nuclear war, no, biological war. No. Some of men were members of Palashika criminal gang and they were possession of 2 pounds of top-grade radioactive materials. Yan, yung mga, again, no? Which can be used to build a weapon. So, mga radioactive materials used to build a weapon. So, yan yung mga criminal terrorism. Example ito, ang, alam nyo, in terms of criminal terrorism, yung eyes ng USA nasa, ano, ayun, North Korea. Bakit na nasa North Korea, Pyongyang? Okay? Kasi ito si Kim Jong-un, ang presidente ng North Korea, he treated, no, he will fire missile over US soil. And that could be in Guam. Okay? So, gusto niyang tirahin yung Guam. Gusto niyang atakihin yung Amerika. Okay? So, yun yung plano ni Kim Jong-un. No? So, he is making, you know, nuclear warfare. No? But, yung Japan, yung nag-testing yung North Korea, nag-alit yung Japan. Kasi, it fly overboard, no, sa Japan. Kasi magkatabi lang eh. Ito yung North Korea, ito yung Japan. Nung nag-test sila ng missile sa dagat, dumaan sa airspace ng Japan. Kaya para kung pumalpak yun, ipupunan yun, baka pupunan ito sa Japan. Yun yung kaya takutan ni Shinzo Abe, ng Prime Minister ng Japan. Okay, so this is an example of criminal terrorism. No? And then, ito yung bago, no? Cyber terrorism. Terrorism that is committed in the computer. Terrorism committed through the use of cyberspace and computer resources. So, yan yung cyber terrorism. Okay? It is out. Kasi nga, ito ganyan yun. Social media is now weaponized. Social media is now weaponized. So, yung YouTube, we know weaponized na yan. Twitter, Facebook, Google, okay? LinkedIn, Instagram, pwede kasi yung mode or medium para ma-spread yung terrorism. Kasi yung terrorism niya ngayon eh, they attack a certain person or a certain place. Hindi dahil galit sila sa lugar yun, but because to establish terror. Okay, gusto nila yung mangamba yung buong mundo. And they can do that through social media. Okay? Example that will be this one. No one who watched New Zealand shooter's video live reported it to Facebook, company says. Ito yung shooting incident sa New Zealand. Yung isang white person din, pumasok sa mosque sa New Zealand na maril. And there were around 52 person were killed. And when he did that, it was live. Live sa Facebook. But the sad reality, no one who watched the video reported it to Facebook or to the authorities. Wala nang report. That's the problem, no? Yung mga tao ngayon, they are into social media, pero hindi nila ginagamit ng maayos yung social media. Sayang. Sayang yung purpose. Na-defeat ang purpose ng social media. Okay? So, yan yung example ng cyber-terrorism. Punta tayo sa world-known terrorist organization. Okay. World Known Terrorist Organization, you know, their Al-Qaeda, ito yung sikat, pinaksikat dati ito eh. Al-Qaeda means the base. The base was developed by Osama Bin Laden and others in early 1980s to support the war effort in Afghanistan against Soviet. The resulting victory in Afghanistan gave the rise to the overall jihad. Jihad is holy war of most, you know. Trained Mujahideen fighters from Afghanistan began returning to such countries like Egypt, Algeria, and Saudi Arabia with extensive jihad experience. So, yung mga jihad experience yan. So, ang pinakasikat talaga yung ginawa ni Osama bin Laden at saka yung grupo niyang Al-Qaeda ay yung 9/11 attack. Itong 9/11. Bakit pala wag yung 9/11? Because it is September 11. 9 is September, 11 is a date. No? Anong ginawa ng grupo ni Osama bin Laden ito? They hijacked 5 planes, nakahijack sa 5 aeroplano, at 3 aeroplano ay pinabagsak nila dito sa Twin Tower. Ito Twin Tower, ito, 2 matalas na building ito. Pinabagsak nila dyan, yan, yan, no? Yan, pinabagsak nila dyan. And based on the report, ang aeroplano mismo, may mga bomba pa, kaya sumabog pa yun. Okay, pag crash dito, sumabog pa. Kaya, itong Twin Tower na to, bagsak yan at naging ground zero na yan. Kaya ang tawag niya ngayon is ground zero. Ground zero yan. Okay? And that is, no, I think, the biggest terrorist attack so far. I can never remember. So, sinong may gawa yan? Ang grupo ni Osama bin Laden ng Al-Qaeda. Okay, ang Al-Qaeda. Now, pero gumanti yung US, no? Osama bin Laden killed in Pakistan, napatay siya sa Pakistan 10 years after his deadliest crime. So, ano yung deadliest crime niya? Yung 9/11 attack or the Twin Tower attack in New York. Okay, Twin Tower attack in New York. So, that's in Pakistan. Napatay siya doon. Actually, ang umatake lang dito, ano lang, Navy SEAL lang, no? Sa kanyang 2 helicopter. Kasi naalaman nila kung saan nagtatago si, ano, si Osama bin Laden sa Pakistan, na si Ruin, doon pinasok nila. At kinuha yung dead body at tinapon sa dagat. Tinapon sa dagat. Then you have the Hamas. Hamas. Ano Hamas? Is the largest liberal Palestinian militant Islamist group. Hamas acronym is Harakat al-Mukawa al-Islamiyah or Islamic Resistance Movement. Yan yung imingin ng Hamas. It is a Palestinian. So, Palestinian ito, Sunni Islamic Fundamentalist Organization. Its name is Arabic acronym for Islamic Resistance Movement. Originating its death in 1987 after beginning the first Intifada or Palestinian uprising against Israel occupation of West Bank and Gaza Strip. Okay? So, sa West Bank and Gaza Strip niyan, no? Yung Hamas group na yan. So, tingnan nyo. Hamas claims serious attack in Israel in 2 years. Okay? So again, ang kalaban ng Hamas dito is yung Israel. No? Hamas incites riot at border to attack Israel. They want to attack Israel because they want, no, to get their land. Hanggang ngayon. No? Hezbollah. Hezbollah means party of God. Party of God. It's a shy Islamist political, military, and social organization that wields considerable power in Lebanon. So, actually, yung Hezbollah at saka yung Hamas, hindi rin magkasunod yan kasi yung isa shy, yung isa Sunni Muslim. Okay? Sa Islamist political laman to, no? Shy. Hindi siya Sunni. It emerged with the help of Iran during Israeli occupation of Lebanon in early 1980s through its ideological roots stretched back to Shia Islamic Revival in Lebanon. So, ang stronghold talaga ng Hezbollah is sa Lebanon. Lebanon naman to. Okay? And they are backed by Iran. They are backed by Iran. So ito, Hezbollah's deadliest terror attack under Nasrallah leadership. Actually, hindi sila ayun nang mag-atake head-on sa, no, sa Israel. Ang atake nga yung mga embassy, ng Israeli embassy in Buenos Aires in Argentina. Ilang patay doon? 29 were killed. Okay? 242 yung injured. Then meron ding Jewish center attack. Attack in a Jewish center in Buenos Aires. Again, in Argentina. 85 yung patay doon. Okay? And during the Second Lebanon War, Hezbollah fired more than 4,000 rockets directly at Israeli civilian centers and communities. So again, no, ang kalaban ng Hezbollah ang Israel. Then you have the Jemaah Islamiyah. Ito yung GI, Jemaah Islamiyah. Jemaah Islamiyah is a Southern East Asian militant group with links to Al-Qaeda. Ito ay may link sa Al-Qaeda. Has a long track record of bomb attacks in Indonesia and elsewhere in the region. Okay? So you see, Southeast Asia, including the Philippines, no? Because we are part of ASEAN, no? Southeast Asian nation. The most deadly were near simultaneous blasts in 2 Bali nightclubs in Bali, Indonesia. So, ito yung pinakagrabing attack sa na ginawa ng Jemaah Islamiyah. Ang Bali, Indonesia bombing. ilan pa tayo dyan? 202 people were killed. Okay? Yan. In October 12, 2002, Bali bombing plot. Ilan na pa tayo dito? 202 people were dead coming from 21 countries. So, mostly kasi yung Bali, Indonesia, ito yung first class island resort nila. If the Philippines sa Boracay, hindi rin nagpapahuli ang Indonesia, meron silang Bali. And Bali is a first class island resort yun. Kaya maraming turista. Kaya in this bombing in 2002, maraming turista ang patay dito. Okay, namatay. And allegedly, ang namumuno sa pagkatakoy sa Bali is si Zulkifli Abhir. Okay? Zulkifli Abhir, also known as Marwan. Okay? Alias Marwan. Okay? And, of course, we know Marwan was killed by SAP troopers in mamasapang encounter. Diba? Pero, kahit na namatay na si Marwan, apat na membro ng Jemaah Islamiyah na nagtago manong sa Mindanao hinahanap ng pulisya at militar. Meron pa rin siyang mga galamay na nagtatago sa Mindanao. O, nagtatago sa Mindanao. So, yan yung isa sa leader ng Jemaah Islamiyah, no? Si Zulkifli Abhir alias Marwan. Then you have Boko Haram. Okay, Boko Haram. Boko Haram means Western education is a sin. Okay, Western education is a sin. In house, a language spoken in Nigeria, Nigeria's north. It is believed that to have a number of factions with different aims, including some political links. Boko Haram is armed group blamed for killing of thousands of people in northeastern Nigeria. May attacks have targeted places of worship, yung mga simbahan, mosque, churches, and even Muslims have been killed. No, pati yun, no, mga school leader, no? May mga babae silang kinikidnap, no? At dinudukot, tapos kanyang iwan, nirewake pa nila. So, yun yung ibig sabihin ng Boko Haram. Western education is a sin. Ayaw nila ng Western influence. Ano itong Western education? Ito yung US influence. Ayaw nila magbilang ka ng 1, 2, 3, 4, kasi it's a sin, no? Ayaw nila magbasa ka ng English. No? You must spoke the native language. So, yun yung Boko Haram. O, Boko Haram. Kasi kasalanan na yung Western education. So, noticeable na ginawa ng Boko Haram, ito yung massacre. No? Boko Haram massacre as many as 2,000. No? Sinunog nila yung 2,000 sa isang village sa may Baga, northeastern Nigeria. O mga lapit sa Chad. Okay? So, yan. Kasi nga, sumusuporta sa Western education, Western influence, kaya sinunog nila yung buong community. And, 2,000 ang patay din. Sinunog, kawawa naman, no? So, that's the pinakilalang ginawa ng Boko Haram. Taliban. Taliban is a pastor for student, no? Taliban means students. The Taliban is a Sunni dito, Islamist nationalist and pro-Pashtun movement founded in the early 1990s that ruled most in Afghanistan. It was composed of peasant farmers, no? And main studying Islam in Afghanistan. So, yung mga taong nagsastudy ng Islam sa Afghanistan and Pakistan or also called as madrasas. Madrasas is the religious school. Allegedly, no, sa Pilipinas, sabi ng Armed Forces of Philippines, meron mga religious schools or madrasas sa Pilipinas na ginagamit as training ground for terrorism. Yung mga bata, tinuturuan kung paano gumawa ng bomba. Okay, instead of how to write, how to read, or read the Quran, they were taught how to make bombs. So, yan yung, dyan sa Pilipinas din yan, no? Madrasa sa religious school. So, Taliban means students. Taliban usually, saan yan? Sa Afghanistan yan. Kabul is the capital of Afghanistan. In this attack, no, Taliban killed 95 with ambulance bomb in Afghan capital. Actually, yung bakit na ito, isang kampo ng military. So, yung mga sunalo doon, bagong gising, early morning na kumakain, exercise. Yung isang ambulance pumasok, may dalabalang bomba. Sumabog yun, and 95 were killed. And it was Taliban who caused that terrorist attack. No, sila yung umako sa terrorist attack na yun. So, that is in Kabul, Afghanistan. No? Then, ang pinakasikat ngayon, ito yung Islamic State. Islamic State. Islamic State, IS, or also known as ISIS. When you say ISIS, that's Islamic State in Iraq and Syria. Kasi yung area of population is Iraq and Syria. Or Islamic State in Iraq and the Lebanon, means Lebanon, that is an ISIL. ISIL naman yun. It is a Salafi jihadist military organization in Syria and Iraq whose goal is to establish an expansion of caliphate. So they want to establish or expand their caliphate. The group was originated in the early 2000 when Abu Musab al-Sarkawi. So ito yung founder ng ISIS. Si Abu Musab al-Sarkawi began to yung extremist militant. So yan yung founder ng Islamic State, no? Si Abu Musab al-Sarkawi. And ang ibang term ng ISIS ay itong Daesh. When si Daesh, that is ISIS yan, no? Daesh. So yan, ito yung area of operation ng ISIS. Merong portion ng Iraq, merong portion ng Syria, may portion ng Lebanon, no? And other part of the Middle East din yan, eh. Okay? So yan yung era operation ng ISIS. So let's go to executive summary. So you have there Al-Qaeda. Al-Qaeda means the base. And era operation to is Afghanistan, Egypt, and Saudi Arabia. Ang Hamas. Hamas is Al-Harakat Al-Mukawa Al-Islamiyya or Islamic Resistance Movement. Ito naman ay makikita sa Palestine. Then you have Hezbollah. Hezbollah means the party of God. And makikita yan sa Lebanon. No? Then you have Jemaah Islamiyya or Islamic Congregation. Southeast Asia, but yung pinakasikat na ginawa nila is yung sa Bali, Indonesia bombing. No? Jemaah Islamiyya means Islamic Congregation. Boko Haram. Boko Haram means Christian education is a sin. And it is found in Nigeria. Taliban means students. And it is found in Afghanistan and Pakistan. Then you have ISIS. ISIL or Islamic State in Iraq and Syria or Islamic State in Iraq and the Lebanon or Lebanon. And magiging yan, of course, Iraq, Syria, and Lebanon area. Okay, so at this point, we will go to question and answer. Again, this is an application to the topic that I have just discussed with you. Yung terrorism. Yung terrorism. So, one, a contemporary form of terrorism that used violence to fight in those in power and their supporters in order to replace existing government with regime that holds acceptable the political and religious views. So, keyword here, contemporary, so modern form of terrorism. Anong ginamit nila? They use violence to fight in those in power. Anong purpose? To replace existing government. So, is it A, revolutionary terrorist? B, nationalist terrorist? C, cause-based terrorism? D, state-sponsored terrorism? So, the answer is important revolutionary because the purpose is to replace existing government. If that is the purpose, replace existing government, then that is revolutionary. Revolutionary yan. Number two, contemporary form of terrorism that occurs in repressive government regime forces its citizen into obedience. No? Piliting yung citizen na mag-obey. Oppresses minorities. Yung mga minority, in-oppress. At staples political dissent, yung mga opposition, pinapatay. Inuulit. Anong tawa natin dyan? That is actually what the world state-sponsored terrorism. Kasi yung gobyerno mismo, the repressive government, siya yung gumagawa ng terrorism. Para ang mga citizen ay susunod, obedience, ma-oppress yung minority, at mawala yung mga political opposition. So yan yung state-sponsored terrorism. Number 3, a militant Sunni Islamist multinational organization founded in 1980 by Osama bin Laden and responsible for 9/11 attack in New York and known as the base. So, very clear, no? Osama bin Laden, 9/11 attack in New York and is also known as the base. Is it A, Boko Haram, B, ISIS, C, Al-Qaeda, D, Taliban? So, very obvious, that's Al-Qaeda. Again, the keyword is Osama bin Laden, 9/11 attack, and the base. Yan, the base. 4. It is a Palestinian Sunni Islamic fundamentalist organization. Its name is Arabic acronym for Islamic Resistance Movement. So, ito ay Islamic Resistance Movement. Okay? And it is Sunni, no? Sunni Muslim. So, anong tawag natin dyan? Letter A, Al-Qaeda. B, Hamas. C, Hezbollah. D, Abu Sayyaf Group. So, for sure, yung Abu Sayyaf, alam niyan. Al-Qaeda, alam na rin yan. So, it's between Hezbollah and Hamas. But you see, Islamist movement, that is Hamas. Because Hezbollah means party of God. Diba? Ito, party of God, the base, bear of the sword. Five. Talib, resident of Lebanon, joined an extremist group which means party of God. Okay? In Lebanon. This group is better than us. So, anong tawag natin sa grupo natin? O sino na sa party of God? So, yan yung Hezbollah. No? Because, di ba, Islamia is Islamic congregation. Boko Haram, based education assassin. Taliban means student. Okay? So, yan yung government. So, Hezbollah is party of God. 6. A Southeast Asia militant group which links to Al-Qaeda and has long track record of bomb attacks in Indonesia. So, ito, makikita, isang grupo makikita sa Southeast Asia and he has a long track record of bomb attacks in Indonesia and it means Islamic congregation. Okay, so, of course, ang sagot yan, nandun na yung sagot, it is Jamaah Islamiyah. Okay, Jamaah Islamiyah yan. Kasi yung Hezbollah, again, party of God, ito, Western education is a sin. Taliban is, of course, a student. 7. AMO is a well-known leader of terrorist group which means Western education is a sin. Ito pala, Western education is a sin. And a stronghold in Nigeria. Wala kasi sila sa Nigeria. This group is probably known as A. Jamaah Islamiyah, B. Boko Haram, C. Taliban, D. Islamic State. So, of course, it is Western education is a sin. It is Boko Haram. Again, no, Western education is a sin. And it is found in Nigeria, Boko Haram. 8. A terrorist group which means students and is based in Afghanistan. So, main students, nakabase sa Afghanistan. Is it A, Taliban? B, MNLF? C, Islamic State? D, Abu Sayyaf Group? So, for sure, itong MNLF wala na to, no? Kasi Afghanistan, hindi naman Pilipinas yan. Abu Sayyaf sa Pilipinas, wala na to. So, Taliban na lang at saka Islamic State. So, you know, pag Taliban yan, sa Afghanistan yan, no? So that will be Taliban. Students, Afghanistan. So that will be the keyword. 9. It is a Salafi Jihadist military organization in Syria and Iraq. So ito yung keyword din, Syria and Iraq. Whose goal is to establish an expansion of caliphate? They want to establish a caliphate. So is it A, letter A, Taliban, B, MNLF, C, Islamic State, D, Abu Sayyaf Group? So very obvious, that is of course, Islamic State, no? Syria and Iraq, also known as Daesh. Also known as Daesh. 10. Osama bin Laden was killed in blank on May 2, 2011. So, saan napatay si Osama bin Laden? A. Afghanistan. B. Pakistan. C. Syria. D. Lebanon. So, ito, discuss ko na kanina. Of course, it is in Pakistan. Osama bin Laden was killed in Pakistan sometime on May 2, 2011. 11. Used to inspire violence and other harmful acts committed against civilians or group persons for political or geographical goals. So, it uses violence or harmful acts. Again, anong purpose? To threaten para itakuti ng civilian. Okay? And this is it A, gang war, B, opium war, C, terrorism, D, Cold War. So, this is, of course, terrorism. Okay? Terrorism yan. Kasi use of violence and threatening. Ha? Okay? Threatening. The civilian. 12. It is crime of terrorism committed through the use of cyberspace or computer resources. So, terrorism siya na nakomit sa cyberspace or sa computer resources. Oh, so, very easy to. Is it A, cyberterrorism? C, B, cyberbullying. C, cybercrime. D, computer fraud. So that will be cyber terrorism. Because it is a terrorism committed with the use of cyberspace. No? 13. President Kaido of Kwanong country wants to remain in his position. He thought of a plan of declaring martial law in the entire country so that he can gain control. In order to declare martial law, he staged bombings in different areas of the country and hired mercenaries to launch attack in vital establishment. Later, he successfully declared martial law and remain in power. The ako pa siya yung is called, so ano yan? Yung gobyerno mismo ang nag-stage ng bombing o nag-hire ng mga mercenaries para mag-launch ang attack. Siya yung ano, gumagawa mismo ng terroristic activity. So this is what we call state-sponsored terrorism. Okay? State-sponsored terrorism yan. Robin, he is part of Central Command of Jemaah Islamiyah and involved in 2002 Bali bombings and was eventually killed in mamasok encounter with special action for subtroopers natin. A. Osama Bin Laden. B. Abu Musab al-Sarkawi. C. Muhammad Yusuf. D. Zulkifli Abir. So, ang sagot dito, of course, si Zulkifli Abir. Zulkifli Abir, also known as Marwan. Osama Bin Laden is the founder of Al-Qaeda. Abu Musab al-Sarkawi is founder of ISIS. ISIS yan, Abu Musab. Muhammad Yusuf is the founder of Boko Haram. Ay, Boko Haram. Yan yung founder niya. So, of course, Zulkifli Abir, also known as Marwan, ay kilalang leader ng Jemaah Islamiyah at involved siya sa Bali bombings. And napatay siya sa Mama sa Panwa. Okay. 15. Extremist environmental group Earth Liberation Front claim responsibility for fires that destroyed dozens of sport utility vehicles at civil leadership in West Covina. This is called, ano tawag din dito? A. Environmental terrorism. B. Environmental liberation. C. Environmental attack. D. Environmental protection. So, this is actually environmental terrorism. Kaya naman kaganda yung intention to protect the environment, but still is terrorism. Okay, yung ginawa nila is still terrorism. So, the answer is environmental terrorism. So, I guess that's the last portion of my discussion on terrorism and other political crimes.